What quickly moves it back up and out.
Johnny, we talked a little bit about what teams have to do in order to be more successful on the second half of a back-to-back scenario. You got to get more mileage out of the fourth line. And you see early on in this game, this is a pretty good shift for Peros and Sutherby.
A very good shift to Sutherby. Deflects home the shot from the point.
Of course, he's already signed to a five-year contract extension.
And of course, that doesn't even begin until next season. Niedermeyer with a shot. Oh, and the rebound right there for Carter, and he didn't get it through. Perreault steams the other way, serves it off on the wing, and a long shot as Perreault is dumped into the goal. But he had bunches of games in Boston this year without goals. In fact, he appeared in 20 games with the Bruins and had only six assists. Big hit in the corner, and it's Kent Huskins who has to get all his equipment back. Impressive young rookie Peter Mueller playing on the top line tonight with Doan and Perreault. Mueller's pass to Perreault, deflected by Doan and trickled just wide. Scott Niedermeyer gets center red back for Getzlaf. He's got some space. Tries to go wide, curls it back into the middle. It went off the post. It hit York and then went off the post and somehow stayed out.
Wow. Unbelievable. And it's off the inside of the post.
The complexion of the Pacific Division. Here's Mueller going wide on the right side, and that one hit Jaguar in the helmet.
Now the Dallas Stars have had the Ducks' number this year as well.
Now Mueller in front, and Doan's hand looked fine on that one as he ties the game. The shot that went off Jaguar's mask. So a second time around, he's got the goaltender probably thinking a little bit, and then he makes that pass, and there's a lot to shoot at for Shane Doan.
Well, there's no question that Jiggy was biting that Mueller was going to shoot again, because...
Oh, an answer right back for the Ducks. Doug Waite redirects one. The Coyotes got caught vacating the zone before the puck came out. Careening into Boynton, knocks the puck loose, and then Scott Niedermeyer can't hold it at the line, and Doan beats him to it back in the Anaheim zone. Doan puts it in front, and Bourbonna put it right on Jaguar with a big save there. Ducks with a successful penalty kill as Bochenski out of the box returns to the Anaheim bench. Winnick gets it in. Ballard jumps into the play, and Jaguar swallows up his bid.
And there's only 45 seconds left.
Now the interesting part about the season series between these clubs this year, Phoenix has won three of the four games, one in a shootout. All of them were in Anaheim as Reinkrek on a beautiful passing play had an empty net to shoot at. Derek Morris made the pass. Under a minute now to go on the minor penalty to Jones. Pronger, great pass ahead to Perry. He's in. Perry tries to draw it to the backhand, poked away by Brizgalo. Of course, earlier this week with the acquisition of Bochenski, Drew Miller found himself the odd man out up front and was reassigned to Portland. Glove save on York through traffic by Jaguar. That's one of those plays where I don't know if Jaguar could even see York shoot the puck. Mueller joined by Doan. Drop past Perreault. Back over for Mueller. In front was Doan. And it was deflected behind him. Doan with a one-timer and a glove save by Jaguar.
What a stop by Jaguar. A little bit of hesitation by the Ducks in the defensive zone.
Paddock escapes for a moment. It comes back to him. Pronger swats it to the corner. Doan got a stick on it. Back to the line. It's held in by Jovanovski. Throws a wrist shot through. Deflected. Saves Jaguar. Rebound was laying there. And Jaguar makes another stop. This one on Hanzel. Verbata into the Anaheim zone. Working on Huskins to the corner. Hits the brakes. Pulls up. Now skates it back out. Curls to the high slot. Lets it go. And Jaguar hangs on. And of course he participated in the shootout drill at the end of practice against these guys for a couple of years as well. The Ducks will shoot first. Todd Bertuzzi will be joined by Getzlaf and Bochenski as the shooters for Anaheim. And Bertuzzi to go first. On the season, he's 1-for-2. Sweeps in off left wing and tries to go back to the forehand. Brizgalov stayed with him.
Yeah, this is a tactic that we've seen Brizgalov use an awful lot in the shootouts every single day in practice, where he gets aggressive with the goal stick. He doesn't want Bertuzzi to cut across in front of the net. Watch what he does. Throws the goal stick out there. Bertuzzi wanted to go backhand, and Brizgalov took it away from him.
You can see the youngster, Peter Mueller, pretty good at shootouts, at least so far in this first NHL season for him. Jaguar has been over 72% in shootouts this year. Mueller, a right-hand shot, scores!
Well, the 19-year-old has got some big-time skills. A big right-hander with a huge reach, moving in on a goaltender that catches with his left hand is intimidating. Jaguar's thinking he's going to try and go high glove. Mueller fools him and goes low stick side and beats him.
Speaking of a youngster with some serious skills and some pretty good hands, Ryan Getzlaf.
Well, this is a big shot. The Ducks need one here.
Getzlaf slow at first. Now picks up a little speed. Gives a fake and then lost the puck. Kicked it up but didn't get the shot that he wanted.
So the Coyotes can win on the next shot. Lost control of the puck, lost it in his feet. He was not trying to kick it up. The puck just kind of hopped over the blade. And Verbata can win it. And he is 3-for-4 this season.
Yeah, the leading goal scorer this year for the Coyotes. He had 5 in his last 4 games before tonight. But he was kept off the score sheet in regulation and overtime. Can he get a big one in the shootout? Jaguar denies him with the glove hand.
He was trying to go high glove, and that's what the right-handed shooting players like to do against a goaltender like Jaguar. And Jiggy, almost like he was waiting for this one. Watch where the left-handed Jaguar is. It's up nice and high. Verbata puts it right in the mitt.
And Hazy, now a shooter that Ilya Bryzgalov is not familiar with. Brandon Bucchensky has to score to keep this shootout going for the Ducks. A right-hand shot. Bucchensky waiting for the official signal. Gets the whistle. And he can keep the Ducks in it here. In on Bryzgalov. He does not. And the former Duck has beaten his former team for the second straight time, both times in shootouts.